what processes that Victor is probably gonna die and like get away. Or I can like look to help if there's like an extended fight.
Okay, and what do you wanna do after?
Catch the wave and then rotate bot and catch that.
True. So let's see what it did here. So you go to mid lane. Good, bottom wave is coming into you. That's fine. Okay, Ahri is bot lane. Is there an urgency to go there?
I don't know, it's hard to say. I should look at least.
Exactly, that's the answer. So here, yeah. There is an urgency because she's pushing for a while and we're about to lose the wave. So right now, you need to go here, ulti the wave, and go bot lane. So you're going to do the tempo here, tempo push, and then you go bot lane to catch that wave. Because if you stay here, you see that you're actually looking to kill Zaya instead of pushing the wave and instantly going bot lane. So you should just tempo push, go bot, catch the wave. Mauka is going to roam top lane. We play for the top tower because Vayne was quite strong. She's level 11. Victor is dead, but I'm pretty sure he has teleport. So we can make this play very, very easy. Because you stay, and then look at the Ahri. Yeah, look at the Ahri.
Yeah, I know. This is so troll, actually.
Hey guys, for those who don't know, my name is Bizyze and I'm a Challenger League of Legends coach. I have over 2,000 of hours on individual coaching and I have plenty of students that climb from bronze or silver all the way up to diamond. Remember that the content that you're watching right now is a personalized, high-quality coaching session that you can only get from me. If you want to get better and climb in League of Legends, feel free to add me on Discord and book your own private coaching session. What are you waiting for? The link is in the description.
Actually, let me do like screen share. This.
Okay.
I did 26.
26. So wait, I was actually, I said 26, 28. Okay.
Yes, bottle.
Okay, good. So what do you think about your performance in this game from a scale to from 0 to 10? 0 is garbage, 10 is perfect.
I don't know. I feel like my auto spacing and stuff was kind of off. And then I didn't push that one wave. I stayed. With when the hero crush, those were like the big mistakes I can point out. But overall, it went pretty decent, I'd say. So I give it like an 8 maybe.
8?
That's fair.
Okay. Good, so let's go into the game. So there are some mistakes, of course. So first of all, we need to analyze the early game. Okay, we go in the laning phase. So far, so good. You respected the Zara Khan right here.
Yeah, my CSing was so...
Especially in the early game, but that's fine because it was first game of the day.
Hey,
right?
Listen, my hands were cold, like I was actually shaking. I'm not even joking. So, I missed too many.
Okay, so I really love the fact that you're respecting the Zyra Khan like this, but let's think about this. So, if they actually go on you like this and we instantly exhaust the Zyra, who wins here?
I don't know, really. Like, if Zyra starts W, I feel like they can win it, to be honest.
True. So Zyra Khan is usually very, 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 very strong. But the thing is, if you stay right here and you go like this, and they are in the brush, you're still going to win it. Just because if they go on you, you exhaust instantly the Zaya, and then Mauka is going to jump on Zaya, and she's not going to have fun. The thing is, if you get chunked and they get chunked as well,
but he starts top lane, right? What if he starts top lane?
The enemy top lane? An enemy jungle?
No. If Mauka starts top lane.
Oh, well, yes.
Then we'll be not.
Yes. Yeah. Theoretically, he should just wait and not level up anything, really.
Yeah.
Sure. If you go like this, you shouldn't really hesitate at all here. Because I think you clicked, did you click back? Yeah, you hesitated a little bit. So you just have to, like, literally go very straight. And if they go on, you exhaust. Because the thing is, they have a lot of damage, but exhaust is going to neglect a lot of that damage. And then if they get chunked, that's still fine for you.
But then they exhaust me too, though. And they still come out ahead, no?
Do they have heal or exhaust?
Actually, I had heal.
Exactly.
Think about it.
Exactly. And heal is really garbage because we have ignite and I mean, exhaust is so OP. Exactly, so OP.
Most used to summoner.
Okay, you try to actually go on the wave. Good. Okay, so let's actually talk about this. So you go on the wave. You try to push for level 2. So far, so good. Good. This is good. Playing slow. Okay.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, here. What should you do right now? Like, what is the ideal case?
Okay, so I want Mauka to step up and throw, like, saplings at him. Otherwise, they've been level 1, so I just have to be respectful of the Rakan engage. I can't contest CS here.
There is no way you contest CSing without Mauka actually looking up. Yeah. So how can you control him?
I can, like, ping him into the bush, I guess.
Assistance. And he doesn't need to stay here. This is garbage. He should stay here.
Yeah, I guess.
So, because right now...
Yeah, he can, like, dip out in and out of the brush, though. Isn't that better, no?
True. It's better, but if he does on this angle. Because usually he wants to stay very, very close proximity with the AD carry. If he stays, like, here, and Rakan goes on you, he doesn't have instant reaction. But if he stays here, and they go on you, then he can instantly jump on Zaya. Because if Zaya is smart, she doesn't stay on this angle. Like, this is in.
Yeah.
She should stay here, Rakan should go into the brush, and he should get zoned down. Because the Zaya is so bad, if this guy is a challenger player, he stays right here. We know that the Maokai has starting the E. The reason why is because he doesn't have mana, so I mean, it doesn't make sense to start double and have no mana. If she stays here and she goes on you and she kite like this, Maokai has no chance to catch Zaya. In which case, Zaya at level 1 against MF, she hard storms if she goes for a long trade. So she could have completely played it better. Here, you should just ping, assistance. Like they play, because you do click back, and also this guy, he's mirroring your clicks as well. Like he's clicking back as well. He's very indecisive as well. So he should walk a lot faster, and he should ping a lot faster here as well. This was good. This I actually spaced very, very well. And here, this is a battle for the push.
Yeah.
But who has the prior here?
We have.
True. 100%. But is your body language?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
you should basically be here, ping assistance, just get those minions, and then just instantly go for them.
Wait, no, I shouldn't step top, so should I? Like, if Zaya just goes on me, then I just trade, no?
Exactly.
Shouldn't I just be, like, go, like, towards bot and then be on the minions, I said?
Yeah, so here, you should just be, so, in this position, wait, not here. Good. If Rakan goes on this angle, on the down angle, it's so easy to go on the Zaya and just trade against her. First of all, you have the minions advantage. Second of all, if you trade with Q, auto, no champion can out-trade you on MF. Well, Draven can, I guess. Just go on the left angle, just trade against her. So here we have small problems with when it comes to trading. But the problem is those clicking. Like here, the E is super bad. Wait, did Rakan start E? Oh my god.
That is trolling this guy.
Holy shit, but you also didn't adapt with her, because you see her clicking. Like here, I would just ping on my way. Because this Zaya knows that this is so fucking bad by Rakan. She's actually clicking back. She knows. Her body language. So we played it pretty bad here at level 1. And then the problem, there is a problem that I knew that it's going to manifest to you because you play a lot. So right now, you get prio. This is beautiful. You're walking up. This is beautiful. So what do you think about this situation?
I mean, we have no lethal here.
True. So what should we do?
I just want push advantage, and I'll step up. So and try to like zone them out of CS.
True. Should we push?
Yeah. I want like a small push advantage.
So right here.
Let's see. So if an all-in happens, then we have a wave advantage.
That's right here. In this position, 3 minions against 3 minions. If you push this wave in, you're going to be in this position. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, I know, it's pretty shit. Yes. So I was just waiting for the next wave to crash and then like push it as that wave arrives, right?
Yeah, so here this one, you want to stack the next wave here and then just crash it. The problem
I realized this when I was playing, like this situation is so bad, like if it is here now, then it's like awful.
So here, if this is challenger, you stay here, Maokai stays here, and they get zoned in the tower. Because Rakan E is like the most useless thing that it can ever go.
True.
So right now, the problem here, if I just want to analyze every click, I'm instantly going to see that you're not challenger, because here, you're hitting the minion, so you're not playing around zoning as much as you should. And not only that, you hit it one time, this is mistake after mistake, you hit it even 2 times, and then after that, hit even 3 times, and then you try to actually pressure a little bit. So you see, this is a wave management thing, and it's autopilot thing as well. Because your default mode should always be do nothing. Don't hit any minions at all. Super, 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 super important. And then right here, how is the wave in this position?
Yeah, it's awful.
Horrible. So what should you do to fix it?
Hardstuck.
Instantly. So ping, assistance. Because this guy is going to just back off. Stay on this angle, push it as fast, and then just go from there. Like here, you should also like stay here, use your W, hit different minions, hit this one. Because you're going to have a rough time trying to one-shot one with the minion. And here, this guy is so bad. Like, where are you going, bro? But you're also not pinging. So we can see that this is diamond. It's probably D2, D3 even. No, I think D2. I don't think it's D3. But here, like he should stay here and he should actually play with them. He shouldn't really bait them. He should stay literally here and just you basically push, he should buy time for you so he can push this wave and just recall. If you do that, wave is going to bounce into you. You have the longsword refillable buy, and it's quite decent. But right here, because he didn't crash and he didn't ping, this happened. And if you remember what he said, okay, I'm fucked right now. This is a bad state.
Yeah. I remember, right away.
Exactly. So this is a wave management mistake.
Okay. Yeah.
So definitely early push. Okay, 350. Okay, so let's actually analyze.
Cheater would be really good here. This matchup, actually. If I could get it off. But...
True. Yeah.
Fucked up the wave.
Okay, good. So you get pushed in. This guy is going to die in like 10 seconds. Okay, so here in those kind of matchups, usually. So what was the thought process behind exhaust?
I have to see what I exhausted first.
So there is Ahri and there is Kled, right? Ahri, Kled, Zaya, Rakan, so Enudir. So what was the thought process of getting exhaust first?
Well, I mean, it's like generally good. I can like exhaust Ahri and Zaya when like go in, I guess.
True.
And Enudir.
But how can... So first of all, let's see Ahri. So Ahri, well, in general, again, you want to get the summoner spell for the lane phase. So let's talk about the Zaya. How does Zaya operate inside of the lane phase with Rakan?
She pokes in there, and then when Rakan finds an engage, she like QC and reads and W's and goes on it.
So the question is, if you don't get hit by the Rakan W, can Zaya go on you?
Yeah, she can.
True, but the thing is, if you have exhaust, can you kill her? Usually?
It depends on like how strong she is.
So it's 50-50 usually. But right here,
like Saya is pretty like strong in like extended rits.
Exactly. So if you have exhaust, it's hard. It's hard to get. Yeah. The problem is that you should get exhaust if you're scared of their all-in potential. But with MF particularly, exhaust is suboptimal. Why? Because they can't hit the W on you. Like if they hit the W on you, if they hit the trash hook on you, you're basically inting. If you watch Words Hansama when he played against engages, he never got hooked. He never got, because it's MF. So you basically get free movement speed with your passive. So you shouldn't go exhaust unless you're playing against a super good all-in. Because here, with this Maokai, like he died a few times only because we didn't have heal. So the rule of thumb is you only get summoner spells.
He was still useless.
Yes, he was also useless. He wasn't really that good.
No, the heal is useless. Not Maokai. Yeah. I mean, that here, guy too. But...
Yes, well, here you could have saved him with heal.
Yeah,
true. Exhaust, if you remember, the exhaust didn't help you at all. It didn't help. You didn't really use it on Zaya in lane at all. Yes, it helped you a little bit against Kled in later stages, but I mean, heal does the same thing if you use it for move speed.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I don't really agree. I feel like exhaust is like better in this game in general. It was either like exhaust or cleanse. I feel like cleanse would be more useful too, I guess.
So usually, I think you're thinking about the mid lane, right?
No, Udyr too. Second cleanse is
Udyr. The thing is, if he catches you, he's catching you and he's going to kill you no matter what. In 99% of the cases, if you're in the team fight and he catches you, you're just dead. No matter if you have cleanse, exhaust, or heal.
Yeah, actually true.
So well, if he's going to run
exhaust
it off,
helps. Exhaust helps you.
It helps a little bit, yes, but it's not going to make the difference between, you know, you getting away or not getting away. And then second of all, if Ahri is going to hit the charm, you need the exhaust. But I mean, if she's hitting the charm on you, you're inting, basically.
Yeah.
So it's not like something like Malzahar ulti or something that you can't counterplay. Let's say Malphite ulti or that, sure, you can't counterplay that. But Ahri charm, come on, you stay, like you have good positioning, you're never going to get hit by that. Rakan W, same thing. Never going to get hit by the Rakan W. And then Udyr, if you're going to get run down, you're going to get run down. So that's why, because if this guy is bad on Maokai, definitely he is going to help out. It's very, very close and it's very, very preference thing. Okay, right here, I actually like how Lee Sin helped you. So this is a good thing.
Yeah, it's very good.
Okay, 440. So let's see. It was this play. Okay. He pushed away your recall. That was very good. Let's see the next one. So there are a lot of things here. There are a lot of things that we can discuss. So 820 is basically this one. Okay, so you got this. You pushed the wave. Good. That's fine. Okay, so what's the difference between boots and non-quiver here? Or, no, double longsword.
Well, boots has more DPS, first of all, I think, with PTA, right? And the moon speed is nice for like helping sets up Rakan W and stuff.
True, so the movement speed is nice, but will the
movement speed... I have perfect goal for it too, so...
You have perfect what, sorry?
I have perfect goal for it too, so...
True.
I feel like it's like the optimal way.
But the question is... The question
and
is...
it also helps with like, getting faster back to lane and stuff. But, yeah.
What alternatives do you have here?
It's either like cloak and longsword, or double longsword dagger, maybe?
True, and maybe you have one more option. Cloak is bad, by the way.
Cloak is shit.
So you can get double longsword and you can get normal boots. And if you get that, you get the movement speed, but you also get AD. You want to think about how are you going to kill Xayah Rakan here? Is it about auto-attacks? Can you auto-attack Rakan? Can you auto-attack Xayah? To kill them?
Yeah, probably not. Like, AD
is
better, probably.
So it's about your ulti. If Maokai is going to hit his W and you ER, those two are going to help you so much more than the boots. And you can get those two and normal boots as well, which is going to give you the 25 movement speed. So here, double longsword into boots, it's poggers. Because with longsword, if he's good and he's his W, you can win ER and then you have a chance to kill them. And in addition of that, you can also get boots. Because boots on MF are really, really weak. You're not really looking to get extended fights. You're not going to get prio to really do something on the river and get vision with the boots. So you're not going to really use the value of the boots here. On other AD carries value, but on MF particularly is not.
I feel like it's good on MF too, because you can it amplifies the strength, right?
True. In this situation, it was better to get the AD, just simply because if you would have to kill them, it's not about you walking up and auto-attacking and just using your attack speed. It's you using the AD. So if you kill them, it's either Maokai catching this guy and it just ER and you instantly kill them, or you not kill them at all. Because they are very mobile.
True. Yeah, I agree with that. What do you think about selling refillable and control ward for like a Noon Quiver?
For the Noon Quiver, it's good. It's very good. Very good. Because you're not going to get poked by those guys. Like, they have zero poke tools. So
what? No. Xayah is like she's just like just poking with that build.
If you're in
range. She does like the area build.
If you're in range.
But like, Xayah Q range is like from like the other side of the map.
Yeah, if she's good like here, let's see. So right now she can't really do it in the tower. Good. Like usually it's kind of hard. If Maokai stays in front of you, it's very, very hard for Xayah to go QE on you. Especially with this movement speed on MF. Especially with the boots. Okay, so let's see. So this play. Yeah, what do you think about this play?
I should just insta-flash her.
True. First of all, you should have just insta-flash. But there is one more thing. Also, this face check is...
Yeah, I ran up for like no reason. I just realized that.
We should stay here and just wait. Listen is doing a play on top lane, playing around Vayne, so you should just stay here and let the wave to come into you. And then, in addition of that right here, do you really need flash here?
I mean, she has like the dagger is like behind me. She has the east, and I get rooted, I'm dead. Huh? So that's why I flashed.
So...
But I mean, I guess Maokai is either, so it's probably not an issue.
So let's look at the Xayah here again. So look at the Xayah. So she QD'd, she QD'd, okay? She QD'd. Let's see it again. So Q, Xayah, E.
Oh, she QD'd right away. Okay.
Yes. So here, we kind of panic flash.
Exactly. Yeah, I know. And the R was also.
Yeah, so there are multiple things. So here, I like what I did here. Trying to poke Q. Okay. Yeah, so there are definitely a lot of... So it was the mechanics part. Right here, again... The same pattern is manifesting. You're going in the laney phase is pushing towards you, and you go to the default mode, which should be do nothing, but then you're just hitting it, and you're like, exactly the time when you're hitting, you're like, fuck, I shouldn't hit it. I don't know if you remember.
my reasoning was like, okay, if I push this fast, I can maybe get it in.
It's coming into you, and you don't have that.
I know. So. But I just agreed for it, you know what it is.
Yes.
It's definitely a mistake. I realized it right away, too. Like,
yes.
I shouldn't do that.
A lot of Diamond 1 players have it. A lot of them. And even Diamond 2. A lot of AD carries.
I was Masters 2 days ago, that's what it is.
Yes. No, just saying that there are a lot of like high Diamond Master tier players that have it.
Yeah, it's... Okay. Yeah, autopiloting is like such a sin, actually.
True. Okay, so here... Let's see. He exhausted. That was good. Okay. Oh, shit. Okay, where was it?
Here we go.
Good. Not here. Oh, yeah. It's close. Okay, yeah, here. this is a mistake that so many pro players do it as well. So many pro players. There are a lot of players that they don't do it. Okay, so right here. You exhaust. What's your priority? Running? Kiting? Or...
Yeah, just getting to tower.
Yes. But do you remember what it is?
Yeah.
Because he's trying to kite, you see? Like, this is something that even double lift does.
Yeah, I know. I realized it as I did it too. I was like, I should just run the tower here.
Yes. Because
you I was like, if Markai engages on him, knocks him at the tower, and I get like two autos, that can make the difference. But it's kind of troll. I should just walk in the tower.
Because just being alive is a lot more important.
Yeah, this should not even be close with exhaust.
So. Exactly.
And the R was shit.
Yes. We're not going to talk about the mechanics. Okay, this one was a big one. This is definitely a master tier thingy. Oh, let's see. Okay, so you go on bot lane. Good, so you lost the tower. So what do you think about this wave?
I'm gonna push it so I can help Drake if Drake's up.
Do you need to help Drake here? So let's actually get some context.
No, I don't, but I want prior so I can rotate in case like Uther spins it, right?
True, that
was my reasoning.
Okay, so theoretically it's a good thought process. It
would probably be better.
So let's see. So right here, the thing is, before you take a decision, you should look there. Theoretically, you need to assume, hey, maybe they will fight and I'll need to be there. The thing is, we have a super, super good vision here. Lee Sin has so much damage right now. We do have prior on top lane. And right here, so nothing happens on the map for a few seconds. So as you can see right now, they're just fighting. The problem is that you're not looking there. Because if the Drake is, for example, 1.5k HP, you do not need to push this because you do not need to go there. So the mistake here, and the thing that, again, high elo player, double lift, or Uzi, or they will do, they will look there first to see how urgent it is to move, and then they're going to take a decision. Here, you're actually pushing, and this is a mistake after mistake after mistake, so you're pushing, okay, didn't freeze, especially because if you freeze here, wave is coming into you, the Vayne is going to push, Lee Sin is going to recall into pat into top lane, and then you're going to freeze forever bot here, and then they are going to do a four-man top play. So this is how we play the map. But the problem was, even the biggest problem, was that right now you're rotating without even looking. Like here, you shouldn't really be here. We should know that Zaya is mid lane. Yes. And you're like,
100%.
Yes, here we go. And then, boom. Okay, good job team. But what about the wave?
Yeah, this is so useless. I should just I don't know, I should freeze or shove.
Yes. Either one.
Urgent, it.
Yes. You should, first of all, you should look there and see what's going on before you take a decision. And second of all, you shouldn't go if it's like not absolutely necessary.
Yeah.
Super, super big one.
I want to say, like, I was thinking about it. Like, I should, like, FQ or something here at least. But, like, my hands were so cold, so I just, like...
Yes, no worries.
I just didn't do it.
Next time you will play. You will play a little bit before. Okay, so right now I go towards the mid lane. Good. So what's your job right now? How should you play the game? So let's see. So why do we go mid lane here? Let's see. What's your thought process? Well,
what process is that Victor is probably gonna die and like get away, or I can like look to help if there's like an extended fight.
Okay. And what do you want to do after?
Catch the wave and then rotate bot and catch that.
True. So let's see what it did here. So you go to mid lane. Good. Bottom wave is coming into you. That's fine. Okay, Ari is bot lane. Is there an urgency to go there?
I don't know, it's hard to say. I should look at least.
Exactly, that's the answer. So here, there is an urgency because he's pushing for a while and about to lose the wave. So right now, you need to go here, ulti the wave, and go bot lane. So you're going to do the tempo here, tempo push, and then you go bot lane to catch that wave. Because if you stay here, you see that you're actually looking to kill Zaya instead of pushing the wave and instantly going bot lane. So you should just tempo push, go bot, catch the wave. Maokai is going to roam top lane. We play for the top tower because Vayne was quite strong. She's level 11. Victor is dead, but I'm pretty sure he has teleport. So we can make this play very, very easy. Because you stay, and then look at the Ahri.
This is so troll, actually.
In the beginning, we said, hey, want to go mid lane and rotate bot lane. That's why I asked you, because you didn't really do that.
Yeah, I know.
Exactly.
I realize it now after, but like, it's such a big mistake because she gets towered.
Yes. Okay, 1830. Okay, I don't remember this one to be honest with you, but we'll see. Okay, so you.
It's probably when I should have shoved the other wave in. Oh, it's not this actually.
Okay, so I get this one. Like, you go towards mid lane. This is good. Okay. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Okay. Good. So you go mid lane. Fine. You want to take the Raptors. We see that the Raptors are not there.
Okay, no, I wasn't pumping the Raptors. It was because Uder was topside with Ben. So I walked in there to like be able to preemptively rotate.
But do we are you strong enough right now?
Yeah, but our whole team is there and it's just Udyr. So.
And can we really catch Udyr?
If he gets CC, then yeah.
True, but then he has tenacity. And what's our tools? How can we catch him? Just Maokai W, right? Exactly.
Yeah.
And then it doesn't even matter if you're there. It doesn't even matter if you're there because you don't have damage. You have like zero damage into plated boots with this champ. You're pretty much useless. So usually when you play the game, you should go mid, you should create the pressure by taking the wave, and then you should make a rotation. So always when you watch high elo pro play, they always push their wave, and then they just rotate. Push the wave, and then rotate.
The thing is though, if I walk up mid here, they're all missing, and my team is like in our jungle. So like if your Khan goes on me or something, I'm just dead. Which is why I wanted to preemptively like hover. And like then as the wave arrives, then I can like shove it.
So what you should do here, so Ari is dead, and Rakan with Zaya, it's pretty unlikely that they're going to be here. So what I will do, I'll go mid lane, I will eat this brush for vision, I'll stay on this angle, I'll push the wave, and then I'll just back off. So I'll try to like fish for it, I'll stay here, I'll E into the brush, so I can have vision and have some sort of, you know, security that they're not there. I'm seeing Kled, Ari just responding base, so I just push the wave, then I back off, because Rakan, it's a good engage. But you need to, if he is on your screen and he's coming, you just run. So that's why.
I don't know. They have Udyr too, though. I don't really lose anything from this battle. That's the thing. I'll still be a hero when the wave arrives.
Let's see. Because you're sharing XP, so you're actually losing. And let's see how many minions you're getting here.
True. Kills
exactly. Exactly. Because it's all about you, caring. And if you give this to Victor, maybe he's caring, but maybe not. So you never know. Okay, good. Anything else? Okay, this one. This one is a big one. Probably the biggest one in the game. Okay. Good. So you take the Drake, sure. So how do you feel right now about your items in relationship to the game state?
Not the best. I'll feel way more confident if I had low dumps. So.
Exactly. So then,
like just right sitting here, a last whisper isn't that strong.
So right here, they're coming mid lane. Let's see. So what should you do? So what options do you have first of all?
It's either like a reset and then just like forfeit this fight, or I just walk in here, press ER.
True, but then what are the chances of succeeding here?
Pretty slim.
Yes, because you don't have item, but you have another option here. Let's see.
Go bots, I guess.
Yes, push this wave. They push, you know, no problem.
They all die, they're gonna like spam ping me on AFK, you know?
True, but you don't have your items. So even if they're spamming you, you're still, because you went here and you got very, very like, if you remember what happened here, you got super, super like. So you went in. So how does it look? Like this looks really, really bad.
It looks terrible.
Your damage is so bad. And then right now when Kled goes on you, it was so close.
That guy completely grifted.
Exactly. So here, you should just con bot, push the way. So this is a big one. And then get Krug. If they push me, no problem. Thank you for the red buff. Thank you for the Raptors. You just get 700 gold just for free. Three waves. This is a cannon as well. Like here, this is what we lost. And you're going to get 12 and a health after this play. Only by the minions. This is a big, big, big play.
I feel like the fight was good though, right?
The fight? You going in the fight?
It was super coin flip, yeah, I know. But...
It was coin flip, but that's the thing. Because as an indicator, you need to be reliable. If you go for coin flip plays, you're going to have 50% win rate. But you need to have a playstyle how you're going to be 2-0-0 every game, 200 farm in 20 minutes. Because if you play like this, you're going to have games when you're 10-0 and games when you're 0-10. You're going to have a win streak of 10 games, lose streak of 10 games. You're not going to be reliable. You're not going to be consistent.
True.
So you need to really play around your items. So next time we're going to do a spectate because...
That was their herald, right?
True. But it doesn't really matter. Because you can't, even if you're here or not here, it's the same thing. Here we got very, very lucky because he was fighting, he was trolling. But you should just play for your resources. Because you're playing a little bit too much as in competitive. Like it's solo, you need to play for yourself. You need to learn how to prioritize your own farm, your own resources.
Yeah.
Okay, 21-15.
That's all I get for what you're saying.
Okay, this one. Okay. Okay, here you said, let's stop the Zaya. But here, if you don't stop her and you push mid and you make a play with the Victor, Maokai, R, and Flash W, and Lee Sin coming when Udyr is top lane, it's so much better. If you stop her, she can actually clear the wave. So you shouldn't really look to stop her here. Maokai did, but
yeah,
again,
maybe not.
Just the thought process of you. Because it's so easy to get the mid tower if Zaya is not there. You see how the...
Should I have an R here? No, probably not.
The Zaya, no.
I don't think it gets that.
No. Okay, good. 22. Okay, good. Okay, 22.
But,
oh, yeah, this is
my main reasoning was she doesn't have R. She has, like, probably a lot of gold. And wants to reset really bad. So if you, like, fight here, then it's good.
True, but you can just, like, let her recall, get the first tower, and then you get pressure. Like, first tower is always more important than some tempo. Because first tower gives you space inside of the map. Right here, big thing, especially in Challenger. So here, if this is, again, a super high elo player, you go, good. Okay, right now, what do you think about this play? So can we get the Nashor? Let's see. So right now, can we get the Nashor?
Yeah.
Yes. Is there anyone that can contest this?
No, probably not, actually.
No.
I guess we can just have top.
Udyr is dead. Exactly. Zaya dead. So here, when this thing is 4.5k, one wave, two waves, recall.
Yeah.
For tempo.
I agree with that.
Do you remember what he did here? USK State. And this, yes, he's good, but he's still not with your team here. So you should recall, we should push the wave immediately right there. Again, so this is something that if you do it, again,
yeah,
that's the difference
we're
between Master.
Yeah.
Master and Grandmaster, that's the difference. Or those kind of decisions are going to make the difference. So this is basically what I wanted to show you in this one. I think that's, 23. Yeah, 23 is basically an exhaust that you used it late. Was it 33? 30. Here. Like, you did it, but it was pretty late. Like, here. That was the exhaust. So you should exhaust instantly. Like, here. You should exhaust.
Yeah, I even said it out loud, I think. Like, should I exhaust this guy or no? Because, yeah. And then I realized, like, he's strong. He has Conqueror stuff.
Yes.
He can kill Victor.
And then here,
I
the flash is really bad. In addition of that, you have D.
Yeah, true.
Exactly. So you can slow him and then Lee Sin is going to get him soon.
Oh, man.
So, but again, should I flash or no?
The
flash,
like,
is always bad, especially against Kledrakan. Kledrakan,
yeah,
Udyr, you're not going to be able to play the game next invite.
True.
Okay, so there are a lot of things that
you can do. If you kill that guy, we get, like, double inhib though.
Well, in that case, so let's see. So where was it? I think it was back, like here, right? Yeah, here. You killed Kled, and let's see what we get after. Even if Kled is here or not here, it's the same thing, right? Because what is the Kled kill going to give it to you? Because he's very, very low HP. So let's say if he's going to be escape here. Let's say if he's going to be low HP, he needs to go recall, so he's not going to be in the fight for the next 10 seconds, and you're not going to be able to get the inhib anyways. So even if he's here, we can't really get the inhib. Because you see that you're killing him and you didn't get anything. Right?
Yeah, true.
Okay,
actually.
So there are a lot of things that we can improve, but overall, you really need to work on playing around your resources, because you have a tendency to play like in competitive. I think that you played a little bit too much competitive, and right now you're playing too much with your team. You're not really playing for your items. Definitely.